Okay, so today we are going to do the Smiths and Oscillate Wildly. I have a hard time saying wildly, but anyway, so another Smiths Friday. This was requested quite a while ago. I remember somebody saying that it was a little different from other Smiths' work. So yeah, we're going to get into this, see what the heck it's all about, and let's just go. Okay, so Oscillate Wildly by the Smiths. So that song was obviously a little different. There was no words, no lyrics. It was just an instrumental, which I saw as I was looking at information about the song. And yeah, I noticed that it was just an instrumental. So, which is nice. I don't really, I guess I would say you don't need words to make a song, obviously. And I mean, Beethoven, Chopin, all that kind of stuff. Mozart, they never had words. But anyway, I don't know. The song, I want to say it was a little mysterious, I want to say. Also elegant. I liked just like I said, I liked that part there in the song. I said just when I guess the music, I don't know, kind of sounds dumb, but when the music went higher, I don't know what instruments like were all there. There is credits here in the description of the song, and it says on cello Andy Rourke, on bass guitar Andy Rourke, And then we have Johnny Marr on guitar, of course, Mike Joyce on drums, and Johnny Marr as the writer. So Morrissey, I guess, wasn't even a part of the song, I guess. I don't know, maybe he was, but not here on this little description from the Smiths channel on YouTube. So anyway, yeah, so I guess I would say that this song really shows what the other members of the band could do, because of course the singer usually always gets the credit. In any band, you hear the voice, and that's like, you think of the voice first. You don't really think of the bass guitarist. Sometimes you do think of the guitarist or the drummer and such, but usually it's the singer that captivates you, because he's the one or she is the one who is saying the words and all of that. But here, it was just a little nice, elegant instrumental, which I quite enjoyed. So anyway, there is some quotes about the song here on just some kind of thread about Morrissey and Smiths fans. So anyway, I figured I would just say some of these quotes or read some of these quotes just to get a more a better feeling about the song. So anyway, this says that it is from "It Mail In Tomorrow," which is maybe a documentary or something. I don't know, but apparently this quote is from that. So it says, "Oscillate wildly, my goodness, is a scintillating instrumental for which Morrissey supplied only the title." So maybe right there they're saying that he didn't do anything else. He just titled the song. Maybe it is a pun on his hero Oscar Wilde. Okay, yeah, so that makes sense. I didn't even make that connection, but all right, yeah, Oscar Wilde. Yeah, I do feel that the song is much better as an instrumental in many ways. It has sort of a soundtrack warmth to it. That's a very good little meaning there. Warmth. There is a warmth to it. I agree. It is perfectly able to impress as a mere musical backing song. It's almost as if it's more enigmatic left as it is. So yeah, basically they didn't need to do anything else to it. It was pretty good as itself. And also there's a Johnny Marr quote. So it said, "We did it really quickly in just one evening, but it came together beautifully." I agree. It says apparently Jeff Travis asked Morrissey to write lyrics, but Morrissey felt that it was strong enough to stand on its own. So again, the song was good enough on its own. The instrumental was good enough on its own. Johnny has also said that it was never intended to have lyrics and that Morrissey supported him in this. So I guess this song was basically just fronted by Johnny Marr, and Morrissey said, heck yeah, and he titled the song. So yeah, this really is kind of a different little tune. And yeah, I don't know if there's any other Smith songs like this where it's just an instrumental. But if you know, you can comment down below. I have reacted to like over 50 songs by them. I think there's altogether 73 I saw on a Rolling Stones page before. But anyway, yeah, I've reacted to many of them, and I think this might be the only instrumental. But anyway, yeah, I mean, I liked it a lot. I thought it was pretty cool. It was good to the ears, nice little background sound. So that's always nice. So I guess that's about it. So thanks for joining me here on another Smiths Friday. Thanks for watching. Thanks for liking, subscribing, commenting. I really appreciate all of the support. And yeah, it's just nice that people watch me go through with Smiths and Morrissey, their favorite band and artist. And I'm learning about them, which is always nice. So anyway, thanks for watching again. I'll talk to you guys again soon.